Does your company need to charge and collect sales tax from more than one state? Well, then you need to know how to add sales tax agencies and rates to QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you sell in two different states that require collecting sales tax, you must add the agency that you are required to pay in to QuickBooks Online. You must also add the rate that the agency requires that you collect from customers as a percent of sales. You must find out from your accountant the rate and agency for the new state that you are selling in. The state of Maine has the same sales tax for the entire state. It's 5.5% on most goods and services. We are now selling from a location in the state of Maine. So, we must add the Tax Department of Maine to the list of agencies, and then we must add the rate of 5.5% as the new rate. So, how do we do that? Well, it's very simple. We click Taxes to go to the Sales Tax Center. And if you look at the top right of the Sales Tax Center, you see a link, Sales Tax Settings. Double click. Now this is the Sales Tax Settings window. It allows you to add an additional agency whom you have to pay and an additional rate. First, you have to add the agency to the list. You click Add Agency. Click the pull down. Now, this is in alphabetical order, but it's broken down by cities and counties first, and then it has all of the states that have the same sales tax for the entire state will be listed lower down. So you kind of have to scroll down here until it all says state, and then you go to the letter M and you get Maine. Maine. Click Maine. There we go. Now, let's make the filing frequency monthly. And again, you need to find this out from your accountant, or you can call the State Tax Department of Maine directly, maybe go to their website. But let's assume that the filing frequency is monthly and that we're starting from last month, or since I'm recording this during November of 2020, I'm making it October 1 of 2020 is the start date. Now, when we click Save, you can see that another tax agency has been added to the list of tax agencies. Now we have to add the rate for Maine. Click Add Rate, and the name will be Maine's Rate. And again, you have to choose the agency again, but it comes up right away, Maine Department of Revenue, and the rate, 5.5%. Now when we click Save, you can see that we now have both the agency and the agency's rate on the list, and we're ready to make our first transaction. Let's imagine on November 28 of 2020, we sold from the location in the state of Maine 4 bananas to a customer named Mary from Maine. And as you know, we can add the customer on the fly. That means we can add the customer at the moment we make the transaction. And it didn't say if it was an invoice, but let's just assume that it's an invoice. And we have to add new for the customer. and click Save. And you can go back later and put her address and phone number and so on. Now, we have to scroll all the way down, and it said we sold her how many bananas? Four bananas. Bananas? Four. Now, it is taxable, so we do have to click the check mark, but we have to choose the particular tax rate. It's not based on our original location. It's based on the main sales tax rate. And when we click main sales tax rate, you should carefully click see the math just to make sure that it has been calculated after you put it in. So 5.5% to 4,000 is $220, and therefore the balance from this customer is $4,220, and the sales tax center will indicate that we owe the state of Maine $220 separate from what we owe the state of Massachusetts. Click Save and Close, and now we click Taxes, and you can see that Maine's tax is due. It's due because we file monthly, and it was due November 20, and actually, to tell you the truth, it shows zero is due November 20, but if you come down to the upcoming, this $220 is still accruing. And the reason it's still accruing is because the date was during November. So it's still accruing, but it's also due because I chose monthly as the filing period. The more interesting result is if you click Reports, Trial Balance. And you can see there is a completely separate and additional account in the chart of accounts that was added to the chart of accounts at the moment we made our first sales tax transaction with Maine. So if you double click this, you get every transaction that accumulated to the amount that shows that we owe Maine, which is a separate liability account in the chart of accounts, from what we owe the state of Massachusetts.